The story of Spindletop and the discovery of one of the great oil fields of the world was the direct result of one man's Texas-sized dream, a dream that took 10 years to fulfill and ended when that famous gusher blackened the sky and bathed the prairie in black gold.
Patillo Higgins was a mighty smart man when it came to oil. The best in the land. He began to dream of Spindletop in 92. It took him 10 years to make a dream come true. Well, it began on a prairie on a salty dome down around Beaumont where he called home. He owned all the land on the Neches River Bend. He named it Gladys City for a lady friend. When the ground starts a-rumbling, then the gusher comes alive, and it shoots black gold into the Texas sky. 60,000 barrels should be pumping every day. It'll make a lot of millionaires along the way. Patilla needed money just to drill him a well, but the folks around Beaumont said it'll never sell. So he ran him an ad in an oil magazine. Captain Lucas came a-riding on the morning train. Lucas wanted sulfur and he thought there was some, but if they struck oil he'd be glad to see it come. So they started into drilling and the weeks flew past till the pipe went a-crumpling from the pressure of the gas. When the ground starts a-rumbling, then the gusher comes alive and it shoots black gold into the Texas sky. 60,000 barrels you'll be pumping every day. It'll make a lot of millionaires along the way. Old Lucas spent his money, but the well caved in, so he knew he'd have to borrow just to try again. He began to smell the oil and it got into his soul. He headed east for money to try another hole. Well, he knocked on doors till he found the right man. There was Folger and Payne and Mr. Cullen, and there was Guppy and Gailey and the Hamill brothers too. They got in on the action just to see it through. When the ground starts a-rumbling, then the gusher comes alive and it shoots black gold into the Texas sky. 60,000 barrels you'll be pumping every day. It'll make a lot of millionaires. Well, it was January 10 of a 1901. Lucas was a-thinking he and Higgins were done. Another well was down around 700 feet, and all they had to show was just the mud around their feet. Well, his backers were a-looking old Lucas in the eye. If the oil didn't come, he and Higgins would die. Then the table started shaking neath that coffee cup. They had just sat down when the oil started up. Then the ground started rumbling and the gusher came alive and it shot black gold into the Texas sky. 60,000 barrels she's a-pumping every day, and it made a lot of millionaires along the way. Yeah, she made a lot of millionaires along the way.